nei a pātai o rua tau nuu manuia mai. Ti mōnga, ma, ma tāngi, yeah, ai pui pui ai rea li'i on tangata. I was born and raised in Samoa, the beautiful island of Uporu and the villages of Satapuala and Waimoso. To my loving parents, to Arapayeli Ipose from Satapuala and Ososo Si Umele from Waimoso, when I left to come to New Zealand on a scholarship. You know, leaving Samoa, you haven't been out of, you know, of the islands for the first time. I remember my parents say, go, learn the Pālangi way, learn the Pālangi words and everything, but do not forget who you are. You can learn as much as you like, but you will always be a Samoan te maitai from Waimoso and Satapuala. I, you know, when you do stuff, you do it because you love doing it and you have a passion for it. And I think I was brought to this world by my, you know, by my father upstairs, by my father in heaven, to do this work. And I hope whoever is going to watch this interview and whoever is going to listen to this interview will get the same passion that I have, one, for our language, our ngangana Samoa. And then number two, for our ngangana Samoa to develop and continue to flourish in this island of Aotearoa that we have now called our ainga, our home. I try and encourage the students to enjoy reading, whether it is reading in English or whether it's reading in Samoan. And I keep reminding them every, and I'm talking about Samoan, I'm sure it's the same with the other Pasifika families, has a Bible. Now, there it is. They don't have to go out of the house. You know, if it's not read on a daily basis, then where else can they go and read? And remember, if you are fluent in your first language, which for Samoans you will get it, or Pasifika you will get it by reading the Bible, then when you relate to English, it will be a lot easier. I think last term, one of the students raised the issue about whangongo. So when they were asking me, oh, miss, what's whangongo? I said, bedtime stories. I said, whangongo was well established in Samoa before the Pālangi start saying, oh, you know, this is what you need to do before going to bed at night. After the meal in the evening, the kids will come and sit around grandparents, and the grandparents will be telling them stories. So this act of whangongo is very similar to bedtime stories. And I said, if you start doing that, you know, the art of listening, if the students are taught and encouraged to have that method, then whatever they're going to do when they leave school, they've got that foundation of learning how to read and write. That's how I feel. There's a lot of opportunities here for our young people. You know, all we need to do is help them, show them, support them, and whatever they want. It's making sure they are aware of what is out there. We must not give up. And it's not an easy task. We need, you know, whamarosi. You know, we need to work together as a team. E loa oe, I lau tū, I lau savari, ma lau tautala.